Hi everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about one of the example of how to use useReducer hook. Okay, so we'll extend the previous video's example. So here we have actually have add name, add email and do nothing, right? So our initial state is name and email, and when you are dispatching the action is add name, we are updating the name property, email property, or we are returning the initial state. So if you just see this, how it is working, add name, it will add name, it will add email, it will reset this object, right? So this is how it is working. How we can extend it and make it a proper working example, you can actually write a HTML form, write two text fields, right? So those kind of examples we can actually talk here. So here we can have two input text field, input type text, and here on change. Now this is tricky part. So earlier we were doing on the on change, we were actually updating the state which is available in the use state hook. Now how can we actually dispatch this? So for that, so dispatch takes two arguments. It is taking like action name, and there can be some kind of a payload also you can pass, action dot payload. Action.payload which will be passing. So currently we are hard coding it, but so here we'll be passing this as an object. Okay, so action.name, so there will be two things we'll be passing, action.type, let's say type is more appropriate, and payload. Okay, so here we have a two input text field. So what we can do is let's write our own functions. Here on the on change, we are going to call these methods. Handle change. And we can just directly write this method, the handle change. Handle use handle, so this input type text field is for user name equal to, so we have two properties, name and name equal to email. And here the name property is email, just to identify the difference. And on change we are actually doing handle name change or handle email change. I mean, we can write a simple one method for this also. Now what we do is, whenever the handle name change is coming back, we are getting whatever you have typed in the event object, and we will dispatch. So here we can use a dispatch, and then the dispatch payload will pass type. Type here is add name, and in the payload what we are sending is the property which we received, e.target.value. Similarly, handle email change. Add email, right? And do nothing means just reset the state, right? So here, this is how it is working. You are actually dispatching, updating the state. So here, it will go to this function. Now we don't need these methods. So it will go to this reducer function and it will check add name. So what it need to be done, whatever the initial state we have, just update the name property from whatever we are getting in the action payload. So this is our action. So action.type, based on the type we are making this condition, and the payload we are getting, and we are updating the state. Okay, this is the simple one. Now we will see how, in the next video, we will see how we can use multiple useReducers together. You might have already seen how we are using the useStateHook together. I mean, you can manage a different kind of state properties using different useStateHook. Similarly, we can write different useReducer hooks and we can manage the state.